Hello adventure riders from around the world. In this video, I'm gonna tell you how I make my videos, what source of information I use, what kind of gear, and maybe the best question, why I make my videos. Stay with me. Welcome back in the channel, guys. This time, instead of talking in front of the camera, I decided to write and talk at the same time, as I usually do when I travel. So the idea of this video is to tell you how exactly I make my videos, what gear I use, and maybe the most interesting question is what source of information I use to make my videos. So let's get started. Maybe the first and most interesting question is what source of information I use to make my videos. Well, guys, I will probably disappoint you a little bit and will let you know that the only source of information I've got and the only source of information I use to make my videos is my personal experience and my trips. I believe that this is the best for me and I will stick with it and I'm not gonna change it for the future. So many people advise that if you want to have the information for your videos, you have to make a deep research, you have to read all the information, all the possible articles you can find. But guys, I never ever did it and I will never do it, because as I said, I believe that my personal experience will tell me much more than the point of view of one or thousand people. So this is very subjective. When one person said something, it doesn't mean that he's right. It is absolutely the same for me. When I have my opinion, it is only my opinion. Yeah, it is based on my experience, but it is still my opinion. That's why, guys, I always advise, always suggest, don't trust internet. Go and make research by yourself. So this is exactly what I did. All the things I already told you, they're coming from my experience. I test everything, so I never talk before I test everything I just said. So this is basically the source of information. I use my own personal experience, nothing else. Okay, how I make the videos, how I choose the topics. Well, usually I talk about the things I believe that they will be interesting for you, or maybe the questions I've got once in a while and I believe that maybe one person will have it now. This is how I make my videos. I never ever focus on that, what exactly is the most searchable topic at the moment, which one of the topics could bring me a lot of views and subscribers. No, guys, this is absolutely bullshit. I never ever did it, never ever. I never make researches, I never work this way. Because, as I said many times, I am a simple guy. I am not a scientist, I am not a physician, I am not a very clever man or whatever you believe that I am. I am just a simple guy, rather like most of you. Everything I know, it's coming from error and then learn it, mistakes and learn it and stuff like that. So when I decided to share my information, to share my experience, I decided to make it unconditionally, without expecting anything back. So there is no reason for me to make a research what is the best, to provide the best results, to get the best results from YouTube and maybe earn the best amount of money. No, this is not the point of my channel. Yeah, of course, I want my channel to grow and I'm happy that it grow very fast and it is much better than I have expected. But the idea is the main idea was not this. So when I get started with the channel, even the people who are very close to me, they do not believe what exactly I am about to make. They said this is absolutely bullshit, you don't need to make it, you're not gonna win, there are so many thousands or millions of people on the internet uploaded videos every day, so you're actually fighting with the giants. But even so, I did it. So just to reply to one of the comments, one guy sent a comment recently that I should accept some kind of positive and constructive criticism. Guys, I'm not in YouTube to receive criticism. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying that I'm perfect or I know everything. No, absolutely not. But I'm not here to listen what people will say, because if I was listen what people will say, I shouldn't even start my YouTube channel. I did it the way I understand it, the way I believe that is going to help And the results is exactly what you see now. Yeah, there will be always unhappy people or people who suggest me to make something else. But guys, I never do it. For example, some people say that I'm some kind of GS hater. No, absolutely not. I don't hate GS bikes. They are great bikes, but they have a specific purpose. And this purpose is not much with my purpose. That's why I don't ride it. And they're not in my segment. I never talk about it because they're just not for me or not for my type of trips. And I believe that most of the viewers of my channel came to my channel because they're looking for something different. They're looking for adventure trips, adventure type of riding, or maybe to reach some different goals. So what is the reason for me to talk about GS 1200 or Yamaha Super Tenere or KTM 1290 and present it like the best motorcycles of the world, but at the same time I'm riding a light and cheap motorcycle? So this is the point. I should give you an example what it is. So this is what I do with my travel videos. I am giving you example that everything I talked, I make it on practice every day, day after day, month after month, year after year. I do exactly what I said on my videos, and this works for me. It doesn't mean that it's gonna work for you or you're gonna like it. But this is the proof that everything I'm telling you, it's coming from my personal experience, and I can stand behind my words and prove that it is a fact. It's a proven fact. So this is just how I make the videos, where the ideas come from. Sometimes the ideas come from you guys. You suggest to make video about some topic or something like that, and I'm always happy to do it if I am able to talk about it. So for example, many people ask to make a riding techniques videos or something like that, but I never do it because I'm not an instructor. I'm just a rider. Yeah, maybe I can give you some advices, and I did it a couple of times, but this is not the point of my channel. My channel has a different purpose. My channel is focused on adventure trips, to give you the main idea of adventure trip, to give you the possibility to see the whole picture instead of focusing on the silly things. If you want to go and watch like riding technique videos, I'm sure you can find thousands of internet. You can go to MotoTrek, Brad Tracks, absolutely great channel. A lot of amazing techniques and tactics. He's a qualified instructor. He can tell you everything you want. If you want to looking for information for heavy adventure motorcycles like the GS 1200, go to Missenden Flyer. Great channel. A lot of information, a lot of specs and detailed info on proper English. Yeah, sure, no problem. Or also 40 times around Tim. Go to his channel. He talks a lot about camping and heavy adventure motorcycles. So why should I make the same? No, I'm different. I am different. I'm coming from a different world, different country. The way I do the things are always different. I never ever listen to people, never ever. But this my, you can say that I am very stubborn or whatever, but it is what it is. I am what I am. I cannot change myself on the 45 years. So the idea of the channel is not to prove myself that I am the person who know everything. Like one person said, oh, you know everything. It must be ridiculous to ride with you. You're a terrible person. You never listen. You know everything. The person know everything. No. I rode with a lot of people, and each one of them could tell you what person I am. So for me, if I'm taking the advice from every one of you guys, at the moment, if I listen 10 people, they will give me 10 different advices. So if I listen 10 different advices, what my channel is going to be? It's going to be a mix of any kind of different ambitions or decisions or opinions, and I'm not going to be able to follow my line. Another one example is my riding style. So many people suggest, oh, you're in Germany, you have to obey the rules, and so they criticize me that I'm filtering now, like exactly what I do now, because it is illegal, blah, 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 blah. Okay. When you ride your motorcycle, you're free to do whatever you want. But please, let me do whatever I want. Yeah, I respect the rules, I obey the rules, maybe not all of them, but that's why I have a motorcycle. I bought a motorcycle to be able to cheat some rules. If I have to stay behind all of these cars, it's better to go with the car. So what is the point of this? I do not criticize you. Please do not criticize me. And this is another one interesting fact. Everybody want from me to be polite and to listen everyone and to respect everyone's opinion, but no one, not exactly no one, there is a small amount of people who do not respect my opinion or my choice. But it's okay. When I signed for this YouTube channel, I know what it's going to be. So I'm not complaining. Oh, I really talked a lot. Let me give you a little bit more information how exactly I made the videos. So guys, when I have a clear idea what I'm gonna talk about, it, as I said, it's usually something I believe is going to be useful, then I have scripts, not exactly scripts, I have outlines, what I'm gonna talk exactly. So this actually helped me to structure my presentation in a better way, to make it quicker and more efficient. So like now, you can see now I have outlines what I'm gonna talk about, so because I don't want to miss something of this, because usually you have the idea, you have a clear idea, but when you go and press the button record, some of the ideas you just miss it, or you forgot something, and then it's going to be too late to edit it later. And this is what I do. I have the scripts, so I taking the scripts, go out, choose the good location for video, and just record it. After that, I need to go home and try to edit it. So if I'm good with the recording, I can edit it easier, but sometimes it took me a lot of hours. For example, the last two videos I've got, they were 6 minutes each, one of these videos, but to record these videos I did it in one day, but it took me actually more than 4.5, about almost 5 hours to record two videos. At the end I've got 12 minutes from two videos, so I spent 4 hours, maybe 5 hours, to record these videos, to find the proper position, to say it properly, to make everything for you guys, just for 12 minutes. And the reason I made it for 12 minutes is not because I tried to reach more views or more subscribers on YouTube, and that's why I started to make short videos. No! I was believing that the videos are long and a lot of information on it, but when I sat on the computer, when I tried to edit it, I noticed a lot of mistakes, a lot of useless information, and I just cut it. And finally, I finished with two videos, 6 minutes each. This was the reason. And finally, guys, to give you a little bit more information about my channel. As I said in the last video, I started accidentally, and finally I keep uploading videos and make it because now the channel helped me to do what I do. Actually helped me to travel more, to meet more people around the world, and make it to gain even more information, which one I can share with you later. So when someone asked me that I made the videos with purpose, many people to watch it, of course I want many people to watch my videos. Of course, this is the idea of the YouTube channel, if you don't know already. So what is the purpose to make one video for one person? There is no purpose. The idea is to see it as more as possible. So some people are not happy, some people said not, I joined this channel, I subscribed because there were a lot of useful information, but there is no enough information now and I'm going to unsubscribe. All right, I cannot hold you here forever. So many people found my channel and joined my channel, and they were very happy at the beginning because they found a lot of information, but during the years they start to travel more, they gain some experience, and now the information they already they don't need so much information now. That's okay, perfect. This is the idea of my channel, to help you to get the necessary information and make your own trips. You don't need to stay in my channel forever. So for some people that said there is no enough information in my channel, okay, don't watch it. I never put a gun behind your head, pull the soft trigger and said watch or I'm gonna kill you. No, absolutely not. If you don't like the channel, if you don't find any useful information, not a problem, go and find and watch something else. I'm not competitive with anyone. I don't have any goals that everybody need to like me or subscribe to me or watch my videos. The videos are here to help. If you're one of the people who need help, go and watch it. If you don't need help, all right, go and watch something else. So guys, this became a really long video. I hope that at least you will get some answers from the questions you might have. And I will still uploading videos twice per week, Tuesday and Saturday. From the moment you watch this video, I will be in Gran Canaria riding for the weekend. So next Tuesday, I will upload a detailed video series from Gran Canaria tours. It will be really interesting. I look forward to go and ride it. So what you can expect from my channel is informational videos twice per week, and detailed videos from my trips every time when I go to ride. So as usual, guys, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Check the rest of the videos in the channel. Check also my Instagram account, Motorcycle Adventures. Always ride safe, and see you next time. Ciao.